Sports Chat 503
from the Southeast Portland.
Coming straight out of Southeast Portland, maybe.
Yep.
Okay. Boom.
Okay. We got it. Hold on real quick. Oh, God damn it. What are you doing? Okay. We can keep going. Okay. I need a moment for the Blazers. It's man. It's like, what are you doing, dude? Yeah. You know, I gotta admit this. I called this guy here after the first game that Portland won in Phoenix, and I said, I'm making a prediction. Sweep. Blazers are sweeping them. And my man here says, I don't know if they're gonna sweep them, guy. You might wanna, double check that.
Phoenix seems good, man.
And Batum gets injured, and it's just like, man.
Unofficially sponsored by today, the Blazer fans who still thought they could win the first round without the MVP.
Yeah.
Where's the offense gonna come from? Yeah. I had a thought. I went to the game last night. So that's unofficially sponsored by. Boom. All those Blazer fans.
Live witness.
Boom. So I went to the game last night. Had our good friend, Daddy.
Daddy Bucks, what's up, man? Okay.
Good friend, be able to hook us up for tickets. And it was a great game until it started. It was awesome. I mean, we're talking about, I've been to so many Duck games. Been to the Rose Bowl. Been to the Holiday Bowl. Thank you, family. Looking out for you. But been to all these big games. Been to all these events. All these things that are just really.
What are you doing, Blazers?
Really just like hyped up events. And it was there last night, the Rose Garden. It was hyped. Yeah. There was bands playing before the thing. People were all dressed up. I saw some people with face paint. They were trying to make the kind of, you know how the NBA teams, they try to like have everybody wear the same color in the arena. It's really
cheesy.
Yeah,
they try to do like the whiteout or the blackout.
Yeah, so like Oklahoma State last night was all blue.
Yeah.
Tonight, Blazers are trying to go all red. I tried to go with it. I was dripped. Had the red Phillies hat, red hoodie.
Yeah, good, man.
Red shoes, whatever, you know. So I tried to go with it, even though I'm not even the real Blazer fan. I was just kind of trying to go with the flow, right? Yeah. That ball tipped off, and there was excitement for about a minute. And immediately, all of a sudden, you looked around and was like, wait a minute, we're down. They're down by 6. Then they're down by 8. Then they're down by 20. So the idea last night was that this is what I got from it. Two things. One, I was in the club level. The club level is great, man. It was you get free food. it's great.
Is that like the suites?
Yeah, the suites. Yeah.
Nice, buddy.
It's not the suites. It's actually a different thing. It's called club level, where it's its own level where you can have access. You sit in regular seats, but you have access behind. The concession area is all carpeted, and it's really nicely put together.
Wow.
You can walk behind and get all sorts of different food.
That sounds pretty good.
You can get 87 different nachos if you wanted.
Are they open right now?
You know, you could like fill your pockets with like peanuts and stuff. So here's the thing. What
There's
I saw was
bread rolls all over this.
What
room,
I saw was this. First quarter, second quarter, big orders at the bar. I walked up to the bar, Guy comes in on the left, says, I got 27 orders. I said, I'm not getting it from this bartender. I walked down the other thing. Guy says, I got 16 orders. I was like, man, people are going to get their drink on tonight. Yeah. I was drinking a glass of vino, as usual.
Yeah.
And I'm sitting there, and I wasn't even watching the game at this point. I had left the arena. I walked on back on this. I'm like, I got the Laker game on one screen, and NBA or Blazer game on the other one, and then NFL draft on the other one. It was during the NFL draft, man. I was wondering what's going on, right?
Yeah.
Keep up for you. Sports Chat Nation, baby.
Yep.
Okay, so check it out. So, fourth quarter, down by 20 points. 22 points, exactly, actually.
Yeah.
This crowd all of a sudden just started, like, surging and literally was exploding with energy. Chanting, defense, defense. Down by 20.
Yeah.
In the third quarter, actually. And then goes fourth quarter. I was chanting, alcohol! Alcohol! Because these people were so loaded by the third or fourth quarter that they were like, I came to this game to cheer, damn it!
Yeah.
Give me something to cheer about! And they went crazy.
Yeah.
Yeah. And Portland actually kind of responded. Rudy hit a couple threes.
Yeah, they cut it to 11.
They cut it
man.
To 11. Yeah. I thought they cut it to 8, but they cut it. But the closest was 11.
Yeah,
huh?
I think so.
The closest was 11, and the crowd was going crazy.
Yeah.
Like they were ahead by 11.
Yeah, no kidding, man.
Dude, it was the fourth quarter, and I saw Blazer fans. I pulled out. They have binoculars under the seats.
Ooh, yeah. Man. So I pulled gotta out. Go to one of these
dude,
things, man.
Club level, man, is like, dude, club level is hooked up.
I guess, oh, man. It's, nice.
I could have eaten 55 hot dogs. I could have had a hot dog eating contest right there in the club level. But check it out. It was so fun. I was like looking around with the binoculars, like just watching Blazer fans. Kind of go third level. It's the true fan, you know.
Yeah,
the guys
yeah.
who don't have the as much dough as the down low. Those guys were just like head in their hands. People were cussing. People were throwing things. They started booing this team. The Blazer fans do not boo the Blazers very much.
No, yeah.
They were booing them. Game one last year, 30-point blowout. Never a chance. Aaron Brooks, 30 points. Yao Ming, 20 points or whatever. I think Aaron had 30. I don't know if he didn't, but there's his jersey. Anyway, he went off. Yao went off. And the Blazer fans just went, sit down. No. Sit down, Blazer fan. This year, same thing. Jay Rich, 42 points.
Yeah. God damn it.
Now.
Fucking Jason Richardson.
But
man.
We both like Michigan State.
Yeah, yeah. And, like, I mean, it's not like Portland doesn't know. The guy's an all-star out of Golden State. Then goes to Charlotte Bobcats and leads them in scoring. And then comes to Phoenix, and it's like,
perfect for their system.
Oh, beautiful, man. Hitting the threes, driving the lane. Yeah, man.
Perfect for their system. Okay, yeah. So here's what I was telling Blazer fans last night. First of all, when I was leaving the arena, I was saying, Game 4. They did not want to hear it.
What an ass.
Some of the guys were like, yeah, Game 4. But here's my thing. One. Without Brandon Roy, you do not have anybody to go to the basket and get those cheap fouls that the playoff is based on. Those little, what the hell? You weren't going to make that shot anyway. Now you get two shots at the line.
Yeah.
Two, if you needed to have that guy, you need Jared Bayless. It's the only guy on the team that's going to get to the rack. Yeah. Blazer fans did not want to hear this. They hated Jared Bayless.
Yeah.
Three, the Suns are way better than the Blazers. The Blazer fans, this is why I'm not a Blazer fan. I grew up in this town. The Blazer fans love their team so much that they also live in the hood, too, by the way, as you can hear the cop cars flying by. Live in the hood. Okay, Blazer fans, they love their team so much, they think they're the best.
Yeah.
They're like, oh, shucks, our Blazers. They still think they're better than the Suns. Yeah. Grant Hill, possibly the best player since Jordan. Injured. But had the potential.
Yeah.
Had the potential to be the next one, right?
Yeah, definitely. Yeah.
Full throttle.
Yeah.
He's seeing the potential of his whole career. He's playing better basketball now than ever.
Yeah.
First game, 10 for 10.
Yeah, 10 for 10, yeah.
Shut down Andre Miller.
Yep.
Absolutely locked down defense and then scoring every bucket.
Yeah.
The second thing is, if you look, player for player, they're much better. If Amari had gone to college, he might be the best college player ever. What would Amari did in college?
Yeah, that would have been sick.
He would have murdered.
Yeah.
Dude, Shane Battier, Andre, or...
guarding Amari.
Amari.
Yeah.
Dude, Shane Battier was awesome in college. Amari would have... sharp cheddar cheese, dude. There would have been nothing left.
Yeah.
Nothing left. So, if you go position, Jay Rich, great in college. Great pro. Amari, great pro.
Yeah, great,
Nash.
Yeah. Yeah,
multiple MVP.
Yeah.
And they're like, well, we have Andre Miller. Well, yes, you do. And I love Andre Miller. But you still don't have Steve Nash.
Yeah.
Okay? And then the guys off the bench kill you.
Yeah.
We had they had Shannon Frye last year. Shannon Frye is still bigger than LaMarcus.
Yeah, yeah.
He plays just like LaMarcus, and he's bigger, and he's older.
Yeah.
And he's from Arizona.
Yeah. Yeah, man, it's ridiculous, man.
And he shoots a better three. He's the same height as LaMarcus, and he's bigger, shoulder-wise.
Yeah, it's tough watching him, man. I mean, God, I don't think the series is done. I mean, after the last two games.
I do. I think it's.
Yeah, I don't know. After the last two games, it's like they can't play much worse.
I also think Phoenix might go.
So
I think Phoenix might meet the Lakers, and that might cause some problems for Lakers. Because
is that right?
Yes.
Wow.
If these guys play like they're playing right now, watch the hell out.
Yeah.
They'll beat. The next round is weak.
Yep.
San Antonio, Dallas, weak.
Yep.
Sports chat. Love you guys. Be good.